We are going to see lungs now. First, you should know how to identify the organ itself. Okay. So the shape of the lungs is conical in shape. That is one way to identify the organ. And the next thing is, it is spongy in texture. Okay, spongy in texture. The color of the organ is dark gray in color. Gradually, it will be converted into a black color due to deposition of carbon particles. Okay, so these three things you should remember: conical shape, spongy in texture, dark gray in color. Okay, so these are the points to identify the organ. Okay, so the first question will be identify the given organ. You will identify it as lungs. The very common second question here is side of the organ. Okay. So to determine the side of the organ, you should know the external feature of the organ. You see here, this area is called the apex of the lung, and this is called base. Okay, apex, base, and it's got three borders in it. So this is the anterior border. If you rotate it, this will be the posterior border and inferior border. Three borders, sorry. Okay, and the surfaces wise, we have two surfaces. Whatever surface you are able to see here, starting from anterior to posterior border, this is called costal surface, and this area where we have the hilum of the lung, this is called medial surface. Okay, so to determine the side of the lung, we are going to very specifically use the anterior border only. Okay, so to determine the side of the lung, anterior border is the important thing. Anterior border is sharp. That is the point you will remember. Okay. The sharpest border, when you are comparing it with the posterior one, is anterior border. So keep the anterior border anteriorly, the sharpest border anteriorly, and the hilum is facing towards the medial side. So these are the two points you will write. I am repeating it. The sharpest border is anterior border. The hilum of the lung should be facing medially, meaning towards the midline of the body. Okay. So these two things you will say. Getting it? And apart from this, you can determine the side of the organ with the help of the lobes and fissures also. If you see here, this is your left side organ. The left side organ has got two lobes in it, upper and lower lobe, which is divided by a oblique fissure. You're able to see there? Upper and lower lobe divided by oblique fissure. Okay, only two lobes are there in the left lung, whereas on the right lung, if you see there, it is divided into three compartments. Okay, upper, middle and lower lobe divided by horizontal fissure and oblique fissure. Okay, upper, middle, lower lobe divided by horizontal fissure and oblique fissure. Okay, with the help of lobes and fissures also, you can determine the side of the organ, but more appropriate way of determining the side is by using the anterior border of the lung. Okay, so this is the first thing. And if they ask you the difference between the side of the organ, right side and left side organ, you can write all those things: two lobes, one fissure on the left side, three lobes, two fissure on the right side, and presence of extension on the left side. Here, over here, this is called lingula. Lingula is present only on the left side, and presence of the primary bronchi. Whereas on the left side, we have only one primary bronchi. Right side has got two things: epiarterial and hyperarterial bronchi. Those things you can write as the difference between right side and left side organ. Okay, so these are things. Sorry. Next, hilum itself is a separate spot. Okay, so this is the hilum of the lung. So they are going to put a needle over here. They will ask you identify the area. Okay, so this is hilum of the lung, and they will ask you what are the structures present in the hilum of the lung. Okay, on the left side, I already told you we are going to have only one principal bronchus there. Okay, whereas on the right side we have two things: epiarterial and hyperarterial bronchi. Apart from this, we have one pulmonary artery and two pulmonary veins. So this is your inferior pulmonary vein and superior pulmonary vein. So we have two pulmonary veins, and these small things are bronchial artery and bronchial vein. We have lymphatics and plexus of nerves also. I'm repeating it: principal bronchi, one pulmonary artery, two pulmonary vein, bronchial artery, bronchial vein, and lymphatics. all those structures are present in the hilum. Okay, so that will be the second question. Identify the pinned part of the organ. You will identify it as hilum of the lung. The next thing is structures present in the hilum of the lung. You will write all these structures. Okay, if you see here, this is your hilum of the lung, and if you go down over here, so this part is called pulmonary ligament. Okay, the extension from the hilum goes downward this way like this. So this part, the pinned part, is called pulmonary ligament. Pulmonary ligament is also a spotter, and they will ask you the significance of it. Okay, so this is your inferior pulmonary vein. Whenever there is an increased venous return, it gives space for the expansion of the inferior pulmonary vein. So pulmonary ligament and significance of it is the one more spot. Okay, and if you see there, this is the medial surface of the lung, and just above the hilum of the lung, are able to see this huge groove there, an arched one. So they may put a needle over here, and this is called groove for arch of aorta. Left side organ, left side lung, above the hilum, this huge curved area is called groove for arch of aorta. Structures large there is arch of aorta. So this is also a spotter. Similarly, on the right side also, above the hilum, we have a small groove there. Okay, when comparing it with the left side, the right side groove is very small, and this is for arch of Azygos vein. Okay, this arch is for Azygos vein. Right side lung, arch of Azygos. Left side lung, arch of aorta. Okay, apart from this, this arch is extending downward into the descending aorta, and related to that, over this area we have groove for esophagus is also there, and this huge area is cardiac impression. On the left side we have left ventricle, whereas on the right side we have right atrium of the heart. Okay, so those things also may be a question. Okay, so these are the things. And very rarely they will ask you bronchopulmonary segments in the spotters. Very rare questions. So you should know what are the 10 segments in the each lung. Okay, you have to read it by yourself. Read it by yourself. What are the 10 segments? Okay, I'm repeating all the spotter questions. First one is identify the organ, lungs. Second question is determining the side of the organ with the help of anterior border. The next one is difference between right side and left side organ. And another spotter is hilum of the lung, structures passing through it, pulmonary ligament, significance of it, groove for arch of aorta, cardiac impression area for cardiac impression, and this is arch of Azygos, area for arch of Azygos. So these are the things they are going to ask you as spotter. Okay, thank you.